modern warfare, low-altitude threats, ranging from unmanned aerial systems to cruise missiles, are evolving faster than ever. Protecting troops from the skies has become a critical priority. Today, we explore the U.S. Army's solution, the Maneuver Short-Range Air Defense System, better known as M-SHORAD.
The new M-SHORAD system is a critical capability that will be able to provide protection to the maneuver forces from all different types of aerial breathing threats, which I define as either unmanned aerial surveillance, fixed wing, rotary wing. And so it would allow this system to defend our maneuver units and allow them to have freedom of maneuver to be able to accomplish their objectives. 5480A is that first unit receiving the M-SHORAD platform, and the unit is actually conducting their combined arms training strategy tied with their new equipment training to ensure that the system is fielded as fast as it can to get it out to the field.
This is the story of how the Army is reinventing SHORAD capabilities in response to emerging threats, where ground maneuver meets air defense to safeguard soldiers on the modern battlefield. A gap in the shield. At the dawn of the 21st century, the U.S. Army found itself at a crossroads. After Operation Iraqi Freedom began in 2003,
it was just over 90 minutes beyond President Bush's deadline for Saddam Hussein to leave Iraq that U.S. warships and planes, there were F-117 stealth bombers involved, launched the opening salvo of Operation Iraqi Freedom. The attack came in waves, cruise missiles followed by the F-117 stealth bombers with so-called bunker-busting bombs. Their target, a bunker believed to be sheltering, what are called top leaders of the Iraqi regime.
Military leaders reevaluated which formations were most essential to ground operations. In the early 2000s, the Army decided to divest significant portions of its short-range air defense, or SHORAD, to free up personnel for other mission-critical units. By 2005, the Army's SHORAD force structure had been radically reduced. Where Avenger systems once stood guard over the battlefield, only a handful of battalions remained. Two battalions of active-duty Avengers in counter-rocket, artillery, and mortar, CRAM batteries, and seven Army National Guard Avenger battalions. However, over the past two decades, the threat environment has changed dramatically. The rise in unmanned aerial systems, UASs, loitering munitions, and new low-altitude missiles posed a clear and present danger. And as conflict around the globe escalated, most notably in Ukraine, these technologies proved their effectiveness time and time again. Suddenly, the Army realized it needed a new wave of SHORAD capabilities to protect its forward maneuver forces.
SHORAD in general, our job is to protect the maneuver force, and being on a Stryker platform allows us that capability to maneuver with them, to keep up with them, and then ultimately protect them from enemy UAS, rotary wing, and fixed wing assets.
The birth of M-SHORAD. Recognizing the evolving threat, Army leadership set out to develop what we now call the Maneuver Short-Range Air Defense System, M-SHORAD. Intended to provide point defense against low-altitude air threats, M-SHORAD was conceived to be deployed alongside frontline units, ensuring divisions could secure their forces from aerial attacks at the tactical edge. Originally, the Army planned to equip four battalions with 144 M-SHORAD Increment 1 systems. Each of these battalions would include 40 M-SHORAD vehicles and associated support equipment, amounting to about 550 soldiers per battalion. Then in April 2021, the Army took a major step forward. The 5th Battalion, 4th Air Defense Artillery Regiment, received the first four M-SHORAD systems. By late 2022, it was fully equipped. In total, the Army initially planned for 162 M-SHORAD systems, 144 for deployment, and 18 for training, operational spares, and testing. By June 2024, the Army was considering increasing that number to as many as 312, and possibly up to 361, though at the time, official approval stood firmly at 162. Increments and Innovation. The M-SHORAD program was far from a single vehicle concept. The Army devised multiple increments, or variations, to address the ever-changing landscape of threats. The Stryker and its arsenal M-SHORAD Increment 1 came to life through an other transaction authority contracting process. Built around the 8-wheeled M1126 Stryker chassis, the vehicle's turret and radar packages were developed by Leonardo DRS, then installed by General Dynamics Land Systems, the original Stryker manufacturer. This unmanned turret bristles with firepower. Two AGM-114L longbow Hellfire missiles capable of engaging ground targets, 4FIM-92, Stinger missiles designed for aerial targets, an XM9-1430mm automatic cannon, an M247.62mm machine gun, and a multi-mission radar capable of tracking ground and air targets alike. However, the Army discovered a critical issue with the Hellfire missiles. Mounted on the side of the vehicle, the missiles endured more wear and tear than designed, raising safety concerns. To address this, the Army opted to replace the Hellfire launcher with a second Stinger pod, doubling the Stinger loadout from 4 to 8 missiles. A new kind of firepower, directed energy. Next, the Army explored a game changer, directed energy.
This thing can take a beating way better than an Avenger can, so I think it's years ahead of what the Avenger is.
Very cool to be part of history. My soldiers are worthy and definitely the people to do it. Very proud of myself and my team for what we did out here this week.
M-SHORAD, Increment 2, sometimes called DEM-SHORAD, features a 50-kilowatt laser as its primary defense. Beginning in 2019, scientists and engineers raced to develop a portable high-energy laser. In 2021, Raytheon secured a $123 million developmental contract following a competitive shoot-off with Northrop Grumman. The laser's potential is enormous. In lab environments and test ranges, it performed well against various drones, but we still face challenges when it comes to threats like rockets, artillery, and mortars. The Army's plan called for a user assessment in late fiscal year 2023 through early fiscal year 2024. Now, the service intends to refine its concept by selecting a few designs to compete for what it calls the Enduring High Energy Laser, HEL, system. By early 2025, the Army will narrow down competitors, fund design and development, and choose a final solution by fiscal year 2026.
Integrating air defense into our scout operations really helps out with our security because we can have our main focus on the ground while air defense has their eyes in the sky, and it just helps us a lot overall with the security and the overall success of the mission.
Soldiers in the field. Initial feedback on the laser. In February 2024, 4 Stryker-mounted 50-kilowatt laser prototypes were deployed to the Middle East. Soldiers put these units through real-world tests. Initial feedback was mixed, with soldiers noting the difference between performance on the lab range versus actual tactical environments. Army officials expect ongoing refinements to bridge the gap between theory and battlefield reality. Preparing for the future. Looking ahead, M-SHORAD Increment 3 integrates the FIM-92 Stinger replacement missile, the next-generation short-range interceptor, right onto the existing Increment 1 system. Additionally, the M-SHORAD's 30mm cannon will receive the XM1223 Multi-Mode Proximity Airburst Munition, MMPA, a versatile shell suited for both air and ground targets. Lockheed Martin and Raytheon Technologies are competing to deliver prototypes of this next-generation missile. A technology demonstration is projected for fiscal year 2024, followed by an operational demonstration in fiscal year 2026. And if all goes well, production could begin by fiscal year 2027. Lighter, faster, more adaptable. The story continues with M-SHORAD Increment 4. On May 8, 2024, the Army released a request for information, focusing on delivering an air defense solution to support dismounted maneuver units. The requirements? A system small enough to be transported by C-130 aircraft, airdroppable, and sling-load capable. Ideally, it could also integrate onto the Joint Light Tactical Vehicle, or even a robotic vehicle. The Army envisions near-term solutions by 2027 or 2028, mid-term in the early 2030s, and far-term beyond 2035. It's a sign that the search for more agile SHORAD solutions continues, shaping how the Army will fight tomorrow's wars. Naming the beast SGT STOUT June 14th, 2024, a moment of commemoration. The Army announced that the M-SHORAD system would be renamed Sergeant Stout in honor of Sergeant Mitchell William Stout, an Air Defense Artillery soldier awarded the Congressional Medal of Honor during the Vietnam War. This symbolic act ties the cutting-edge system to a legacy of valor and sacrifice. Fielding the force. Following the first two M-SHORAD battalions, the 5th Battalion, 4th Air Defense Artillery in Germany, and the 4th Battalion, 60th Air Defense Artillery at Fort Sill, Oklahoma, the Army is now equipping the 6th Battalion, 56th Air Defense Artillery at Fort Cavazos, Texas. A 4th Battalion will stand up at Fort Liberty, North Carolina by the third quarter of fiscal year 2025, indicating a growing expansion of these vital air defense assets, transforming the future. On February 27, 2024, the Army published its Army Force Structure Transformation White Paper. Within its pages, a bold plan, 4 more M-SHORAD battalions set to expand the Army's protective umbrella. By June 14, 2024, officials stated these additional battalions would likely be activated in the Army National Guard, contingent on future funding across the program objective memorandum between fiscal year 2026 and fiscal year 2030. Where these battalions will be stationed and how they'll be resourced is an ongoing question, one that Congress will undoubtedly scrutinize. From budgets to training areas to modernization objectives, the path ahead involves many critical decisions. Lessons from the front. The conflict in Ukraine offers a sobering lens into modern warfare. Both sides have employed not only conventional fixed and rotary wing aircraft, but also commercial and military UASs used for surveillance, target acquisition, and even direct strikes. Loitering munitions, also known as kamikaze or suicide drones, have made a formidable impact on the battlefield. For U.S. lawmakers, these observations are critical. Congress may question how these lessons translate into M-SHORAD design improvements. Are we effectively adapting to drone swarms, advanced jamming, and new threat tactics? How do we ensure M-SHORAD remains agile, lethal, and reliable, no matter the environment? M-SHORAD, now the SGT Stout, represents more than just a new piece of military hardware. It's a reaffirmation of the Army's commitment to safeguard maneuver forces against air threats, old and new. From Increment 1's robust missile loadout to the promise of directed energy weapons, the Army's shields on the move serve as both a stopgap and a glimpse into the future of warfare. Still, the journey is far from complete. Debates over funding, technology, and force structure remain. The Army and Congress must confront these questions head-on, ensuring that America's soldiers have the protection they need when they need it most. In a new era of multi-domain operations, where threats can come from anywhere, at any time, M-SHORAD stands at the cutting edge of battlefield defense. As the Army continues to transform, so too will its shield on the move, securing the skies above the boots on the ground.